Hello, I am Reinout and this is Arkhane, an Allosaurus. But today we will talk about this little fella, a Nanosaurus. This species was found next to Arkhane and probably was its late night snack. Look at this skeleton. It's so fragile. We are very lucky to find any fossilized remains after 155 million years, especially skulls. Fossilized skulls are quite rare. They detach very easily from the rest of the skeleton and they are often squashed. The little skulls, even more so. But paleontologists found this Nanosaurus skull. It's so rare and so unique that we barely dare to touch it. But that's where technology comes in. We are now in the scanning room and I'm with Pascal Godefroit, who studied the Nanosaurus. Hi, Pascal.
Hello, Reinout.
Why do you want to scan this skull?
You know, this Nanosaurus skull is nicely preserved. Mm-hmm. It's the best in the world, but it remains extremely fragile. And if we want to look what is inside the skull mm-hmm. without touching the actual bone, we need to use this micro CT scan. Now the Nanosaurus skull was completely scanned, and what we will try to do is to remove the sediments virtually, of course, and look what happens inside the skull. Here you can see bones that are in fact completely hidden by sediment in the actual skull. So now we will try to isolate each bone separately, then to attempt a 3D reconstruction of the skull.
We are here in my favorite spot, the fossil preparation lab. And this is the only loose piece of Nanosaurus jawbone found during the excavations. And my colleague Aldo will now integrate this real piece into the 3D model. Jonica is now texturing the skull, so you can't see the difference between the real and the fake. It's a wrap! This is one of the most complete Nanosaurus specimens today. Thanks to new and old methods, we now have a pretty accurate picture of this little plant-eating dinosaur from the Jurassic.